legends are inside all of us, waiting to be born. ECW Universe, I'd like to personally welcome each and every one of you here tonight to Raw. I apologize for being on the road here with a pre-recorded message. I would have liked to shoot this live from Silver Dollar City in Branson, Missouri, but apparently my GPS has taken me through the most rural part of Missouri en route to the show tonight, so I wanted to make sure, per the Board of Administration, that I get this to you all on time, and I don't have to have our social media representatives who run our official page type up some long message for y'all to read instead and hand that off to Brian Cole, so on and so forth. So with that being said, Money in the Bank, King of the Extreme 2, possibly the biggest pay-per-view since WrestleMania is what I'm being told. I've read it all over the internet, the review, social media, everywhere, that we have broke records with that event. So, without further ado, the 12 men involved in the tournament, the 6 men involved in Money in the Bank, thank you all for everything you've done for ECW and putting on one of the greatest events in this company's brief history. Now, with that being said, congratulations are in order for AJ Hawks and Jeremy McGlasson here. your big wins, respectively, for the Knights. Also, with that being said, you're not going to be seeing the likes of Mazaska Hojo, Kyle Parks, or Ryan Asriel here tonight as a result of things that transpired last night. Ryan Asriel, as you all saw, withstood one of the craziest superplexes I've ever seen in professional wrestling, being superplexed from a ladder to the outside of the ring through a table. We're being told Ryan Asriel is okay, but is going to need a little bit of time to recover following that, and we're hoping to see him back in the next few weeks. As far as Jeremy McLaughlin and Battleground is concerned, Jeremy, by next week this time, you will know who your number one contender is. I will be back to announce it myself. Furthermore, Mazaska Hojo, everybody saw what happened to him in the Hell in a Cell match. That big son of a bitch. Can't believe I'm saying this about someone of his stature and demeanor, but there is no date set right now for his return. He took a very nasty fall in that match in the hands of Ryan Asriel. As for Kyle Parks, I mentioned Kyle Parks will not be here tonight. Kyle Parks was violently attacked by Mike Giacchino yet again, making the second night of that last month. And apparently Mike Giacchino and Kyle Parks, you both still have some kind of beef you have yet to squash. So here's what's going to happen. First of all, Mike Giacchino, I hope you're ready for action tonight, because you are officially reinstated. Apparently, suspending you isn't going to do the job. So, what's going to happen is, tonight, one of the men you attacked on SmackDown, your former best friend Ross Wheatley, is going to get a little bit of retribution, and he's going to face you in the opening contest tonight on Raw. Now, moving forward from that, another man that you've laid hands on in recent weeks, next week on Raw in the main event, Kyle Parks and Aether Adams, excuse me, got tongue-tied. They're going to have the opportunity to choose a partner of their own. They can get together and decide on who they want that to be. And Mike Giacchino, on that main event next week on Raw, you will choose two partners of your own for a six-man tag match. And hopefully that'll settle this beef between y'all. If not, because I know how you boys think in the back, here's what's going to happen. Kyle Parks, if your team wins, Mike Giacchino, if your team wins, then you and Kyle, Mike and Kyle that is, will meet again at Battleground in 4 weeks. The winning team dictates that either Mike Giacchino or Kyle Parks will choose the stipulation for your match at Battleground. Then, hopefully, that will put this to bed, and you all can go about your business. Speaking of you, Mike Giacchino, since you seem to be such a hot topic these days, the judge is recovering. He has been going through rehabilitation, physical therapy. Now, I don't have a date on his return yet. I don't know that we'll see him in the ring again, thanks to what Mike Giacchino did to him roughly a month ago. But the judge is recovering, and we can be thankful for that at least. Now, with that all being said and done, I've been diligently working on our next pay-per-view event, Battleground, and I do have some news for it. The Board of Administration and I have been putting together some prospective matches for it, and I am proud to announce that we will be reinstating a tradition from the year before. Last year we did it at Payback, some of you might recall. This year we are doing it at Battleground, and not only are we doing it at Battleground, we are sticking around Missouri there. We will be coming to you live for Battleground from the Scott Air Force Base there, right outside of St. Louis. And as you could probably put the numbers together here, crunch them yourself, Battleground will be our official Tribute to the Troops annual broadcast on the ECW Network. So with that being said, guys, I hope you're ready. We're going to, as I said it a year ago, pay it forward to the troops again, put on a hell of a show for all of our men and women who are serving our fine country. Other than that, that's really all I have to say. So, ladies and gentlemen, I hope that you all are well and prepared for a great night of wrestling action here from ECW. I know I am. I'll be watching from the back, keeping an eye on things. Excuse me. That being said, we will be announcing the official matches for Battleground here very soon. But in the meantime, to the guys in the back, take care of yourselves. Money in the Bank was a very hellacious show. I know I've been there before. I've been in those types of matches before. I know what it can do to your body. So take it easy tonight. Don't take too many risks, but be sure that we still put on a hell of a show. To everybody watching at home, definitely tip your hats. Standing ovation, round of applause to the men who participated in Money in the Bank and King of the Extreme. And for myself and for everybody else here, welcome to Monday Night Raw. Ladies and gentlemen, there you have it from Ryan Jones himself, the self-proclaimed Newfound Messenger of the Board of Administration. It seems to me that he is regaining his position as the owner of this company slowly but surely, which is not a bad thing as right now with the judge out of action, and it sounds like for the foreseeable future, there needs to be somebody here at the helm of the company. The Board of Administration can only do so much. They prefer to stay within their conference room. So, quite the update there from Ryan Jones. As we take a look ahead at some of the things we're talking about here tonight, opening up with a huge one-on-one match, the Implosion of the Sun Bros. Any of you will recall the Sun Bros tag team run late in the first year of ECW. Mike Giacchino and Ross Wheatley. Mike Giacchino attacked Kyle Parks and Ross Wheatley with their match on SmackDown this last year. Following that, there's a rematch between SMC and Dashy Gassy Bones. And following that, the Gassy Bones, the brother of Dashy Gassy Bones and the partner of SMC, takes on Dash's partner, Terry Wall. That should be an exciting... That's going to be an exciting one-on-one match as well. And then following that, we have Shawn Knight and AJ Hawk locking it up yet again, trying to really get over each other here, get past one another. See who the better man is. AJ Hawk kept his promise, became Mr. Money in the Bank. And a big congratulations to him. Shawn Knight came up short in that match, and you know he's going to have a chip on his shoulder as a result. And look at this main event, folks. Wade White gets a shot at the new ECW World Heavyweight Champion, Jerry the Glasson. All that and so much more coming to you guys here tonight on Raw. We are proud to be sponsored by Powerade and JC Penney. JC Penney's got a big holiday sale going on right now. Be sure to check it out.
Fire on the nail of them, die! Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Mike Giacchino entering the ring right now as we speak. It embarrassed me here tonight. My sinuses are giving me a lot of grief here at the announce table. Trying to cover all of the action and breathing my mouth at the same time. It's going to be a little bit of extra work for old Brian Cole here, but I will persevere and I will get the job done for you, ECW Universe. I have to give a huge shout out to my helpful hands in the back who are providing me with a box of Kleenexes right now. And Mike Giacchino wearing a new shirt here. Looks like he's representing St. Louis. I'm not sure what the 700 block is. But he's obviously proud of where he comes from. Here's another man who's proud of where he comes from. And only from Asgard itself. This will be an interesting meeting between these two. These two train together. Ross Wheatley with Mike Giacchino. Put up with a training regiment that many members of the ECW locker room adhere to still to this day. Open up, Mike Giacchino quickly. Oh no, German suplex right from the opening bell. And there's not a single motion here, going straight to the leg. And this is what many people had wondered, if he would hold back at all on his former tag team partner. And right now, it looks like the answer is not at all. Counter whip into the turnbuckle. Ross immediately counters with a kick to the midsection. Counter that front neck lock and a Russian leg sweep from the machine. Machine officially back in action. Violated his suspension. Many people wondered at Money in the Bank last night if that would be something that would cost him. And it actually, shockingly enough, and I'll say it again, I don't agree with it. Seems like it's actually paid off for him. I'm not sure what to think of this. I hate to say it, but I want to say the board of administration might actually be intimidated by Mike Giacchino. Mike Giacchino seems to think that it's all Ryan Jones and the judge trying to hold him down, but who knows? If he locks in this Achilles tendon lock here on the ankle, look at this. High-level grappling and submission skill there. Ross Wheatley barely able to get back to his feet from that. Oh, the power slam there. Took the world into a sidewalk slam. Mike Giacchino, no, just knocked off the top rope and he crashes to the floor outside. Ross Wheatley almost made it to the final round of the King of the Extreme tournament last night. Wait a second, Mike with a curb stomp on the floor. And the damage looks like it's been done. Ross Wheatley might be knocked out from that. Mike Giacchino is already celebrating in the ring. Ross Wheatley gets back in. What's this going to be? Oh, and a chop block to the knee. Taking the leg there again. The damage has definitely been done. And there's the ankle lock in the middle of the ring. There's nowhere for the Thunder God to go. And he's pulling him away from the rope. That's it. He's tapping out. Mike Giacchino making short work of his former best friend here tonight. Well, title or not, Mike Giacchino continues to pick back up where he left off, dominating the roster here. And now the question is, next week, who is going to be Mike Giacchino's partners? And who will Aether Adams and Kyle Parks choose for their third man, that huge six-man tag, where it appears that the winning team, whether it's Kyle Parks' team or Mike Giacchino's team, Mike or Kyle Parks will be choosing the stipulation for their match at Battleground, which, according to Ryan Jones, we are anticipating to be the final confrontation between these two. Well, moving ahead, it's time for our next matchup, folks. And following that Raw before King of the Extreme, Money in the Bank 2. Oh, let me correct myself. It wasn't that Raw. It was actually, it would have been 2 weeks ago from today. The third week of June. Excuse me. Yes, the third week of June it would be. The Ashley Bones and Steve McCarty was scheduled for one-on-one competition. Steve McCarty decided to pick a fight with the returning Kyle Parks and paid for it dearly, which allowed Dashing Nasty Bones to pick up an easy victory that night. A very easy victory, and Steve McCarty has not been happy about it ever since. Which leads us to where we are here tonight. Here comes Dashing Nasty Bones. He's got a little bit of an air of confidence to him, despite not having his watch going the way he had hoped in that tournament. But it seems that S&T, his watch didn't make it past the first round either. But Dash is 1-0 against S&T here. So you guys think Dash thinks he can go 2-0 just as easily here tonight. Don't want to underestimate the tough guy, but you know, when you got a win in the win column, it's a win in the win column, that's what it is. Thank you. Here we go. Both men not even grappling at all. Just going straight for the strike here. They want to slug this one out and get it over with. Aston McKee trying to take advantage here of a down dash after that counter. And third for, oh, do a face crusher. Oh my goodness. Rolling out there, Dash gonna follow him. They're gonna take this thing to the outside right in front of us. Oh no. Oh, running leg trip STO takedown there. Dash looks like he's in the driver's seat right now. Nice shoulder block from the top guy. Now shrugs them off and they lock up. Finally they lock up here. They've just been trading blows. They've been going back and forth with big offense right from the start. SMC now with a nice rear chin lock. Oh, applying some pressure. He's trying to realign the jaw. There's a knee to the back. Gosh, kind of a neck breaker there and regained a little bit of control. Oh, throws into the turnbuckle. And what a sidewalk slam from the tough guy. All the way around, that's got to be enough. One, no, not even a one count. Dash powers through it. And again, the turnbuckle. SMC's going to take a high risk here. Setting him up on the top rope for something big. What is this going to be? Avalanche Samoan drop right into the middle of the ring. Now we're going to see a little bit of the flying tough guy as he drops an elbow. Right across the chest there. Dash really felt the effects of that one. And again, Kent was just slugging it out here. Hooks him for a vertical suplex. Look at the hang time as he drops him down. This is not how Dash foresaw this match going. Excuse me. And oh no, power slams him right in front of us again. You know, ever since SNC has aligned himself with Dash's brother, the former tyrant, McNasty Bones, SNC's always had a mean streak, but this is not a mean streak. This is just cold-blooded ruthlessness here. And, oh, right off of our reinforced table. And an uppercut from the tough guy. Good Lord Almighty. He's just trying to knock Dash McNasty Bones in the next week. Dash trying to mount some kind of an offensive comeback here. Oh, blocks him with that elbow to the side of the head. SMC lifts him up. The big sit-out powerbomb. One, two, and good night, Dash. That is enough for the tough guy tonight. Donnie had it with that big slam there in the ring. And look at this is the end. That big power bomb, the toughest power bomb in ECW. SMC here commanding some respect from the official and from this audience here in Silver Dollar City, Branson, Missouri. It doesn't seem like these Missouri folks are too keen on the tough guy right now. He's telling the referee that he doesn't even need his help. He can raise his own damn hand.
Well, ECW, it was a pretty long, hard, pretty tough fucking battle. You know, AJ, you did pretty good, I suppose. I guess I got a little too caught up trying to make sure nobody else would win, that you just slipped through my little fingers. But that's cool, man. You deserve it. Maybe that's what you need to finally get yourself a proper push. You know, I don't really need money in the bank. You know, I've been the top dog a couple times. Kind of like old Jeremy McGlasson now. But knowing that fucking Jeremy McGlasson is our champion, I kind of got an itch for the gold again. Might be Jeremy McGlasson. Might be BTB. Could go for some hardcore gold. Who knows? Well, it's about to be the gold rush again, like 1849. So, I'll keep y'all posted. I'll keep you updated. I'll let you know what's happening. So, in the meantime, prepare yourselves, my friends.
Nasty Bones finally seeming to get some kind of focus back in his life here. And it seemed like after he lost that huge matchup, the co-main event that was at WrestleMania, to the judge, he seemingly fell off the grid other than making an abrupt return just to attack one Acer Adamus weeks before Extreme Rules. He hasn't really had a lot of direction. He picked up SNC along the way as a protege, as a student, as a disciple, or pupil, whatever you want to call him. And really, yeah, it's in the Money in the Bank match in true Nasty Bones fashion, I suppose. Not even interested in a possible chance of becoming a three-time world heavyweight champion, no. Nasty Bones says he doesn't need the world championship. He doesn't need Money in the Bank. But now, possibly becoming a two-time hardcore champion, an intercontinental champion. Well, I mean, what could Nasty Bones even have up his sleeve? Here we go, Terry Wall, Dash McNasty Bones. McNasty Bones. That would be McNasty Bones' brother that just was in the last battle. But those McNasty Bones brothers, they bear an awful close resemblance here, so excuse me for getting them confused. That would be McNasty Bones in the green and black. Terry Wall in the tannish, silverish, brown colors there and black. Oh, there's a big boot from McNasty Bones. And Terry Wall, one of the biggest fights of his career here at ECW. He's fought some big names like Jeremy McGlasson in the past, but this is definitely his biggest and most challenging opponent yet. STF for McNasty Bones, but he's in the ropes. McNasty Bones is giving him no room to breathe here, right from the opening bell, all over the big draw. Terry Wall's trying to fight back, and they'll lock up. Terry Wall overpowers him, but look at this little scare down, they lock up again. Nationals and gains control. Misses that running shot. Oh, quick punch. Spins him around, and what a falling slam. Look at that, took the leg. 1-2, almost a three count there. Really favored that faraway slam here of late. Oh, big stiff shot to the back. What's this going to be? And look, a second one again, and he hooked the other way. 1-2, no. Terry Wall able to get the shoulder up yet again. So wait a second now, the poison mist loaded and blinding the big brawl. Shoots him into the turnbuckle. What is he going to do here? Big flapjack right into the center of the ring. Not what Terry Wall is wanting. Oh, throws him down the back of his head. And Nasty Bones zeroing in. This is what he wants right here. Got him around the throat. Look at the strength as he spins him around in a choke slam. What a choke slam from the Nasty Bones. Terry Wall is not a small man, and there's a three count. This one is in the book. Look at this. Spins him 180 degrees in the opposite direction and just plants him. History will tell you, folks, there's a long, long list of men who have fallen to that same maneuver. Nasty Bones has defeated the name of names here in this company. And Terry Wall just got buried with the rest of them.
ECW, I told you what I was gonna do. I said that I would ascend the ladder. I would take money in the bank, and it would be mine. I told you, McNasty Bones, that I was focused and my eyes were on the prize. I told you, Sean Nice, that I was focused. My eyes were on the prize. And now, look what we have. Both of you on the outside looking in. I'm Mr. Money in the Bank. Do you know what that means? I'll tell you. I'm the next ECW World Heavyweight Champion. And speaking of that, congrats, Jeremy. It's amazing how things come full circle. You think that if I cash in, and you don't know when I'm going to do it, but you think when I cash in that I'm going to lose and I'm going to have to retire? Not at all, buddy. Not at all. Gonna come full circle, and then I will be the only man to not only retire you, but retire you and take a belt from you. Now, I want all that to resonate with everybody as Raw starts tonight, and I take Sean Nice,
and I finish what we started, and I put him out. I'm Mr. Money in the fucking bank. My future is golden, and everybody else's fate is sealed when I cash in and become new heavyweight champion. But you don't know. But you don't know. You don't know when I'm gonna do it. You have no idea. And I'm like the last two. I'm gonna win. I'm gonna fucking win.
Well, there's some words from Mr. Money in the Bank, AJ Hawks, and here he comes. Wait a second, Sean Nice from behind. Sean Nice is saucing Mr. Money in the Bank from behind. Oh my gosh, Sean Nice laid him out on the entrance ramp. And this is just supposed to be a singles match here. The referee is coming over here to the broadcast position. He made his way back around now and give word that this is now a Falls Count Anywhere match. Sean Nice is all over AJ Hawks. They've not even made it into the ring. Sean Nice is just trying to pick him apart here. But AJ counters, and Ron Edwards tries to steal this with a roll-up. One, Sean Nice counters right back. And AJ Hawks is able to escape. That blindside attack has taken so much out of AJ Hawks after both these men went through that intense Money in the Bank ladder match last night. Like any of the six of those men are even here tonight. Oh, and again, Sean Nice's sole attack here has been on that arm. Oh, a kick to the head. AJ Hawks trying to make some kind of an offensive comeback here. And a counter and another roll-up. Sean Nice able to counter it again. I don't think Sean wants to win this in the pinfall anyway. I think he wants to send a message. Uppercut there, AJ Hawks turns up, throws him into the barricade. But headlock here, what's Sean Nice looking for? Oh, there's a big forearm shot. AJ Hawks with a knee lift. And a flying knee to follow it. Countered by Sean Nice, Russian leg sweep to the, oh, head first into the barricade. Drops him right on the back of his head. Gonna kick those feet now, misses. Another flying knee there for AJ Hawks. AJ, oh, it's Florida suplex. Dropping a knee now. Again, AJ Hawks is just trying to get this thing over with. He said he planned on finishing off Sean Nice here tonight, but Sean Nice caught him off guard. Oh, throws AJ into the barricade. And what is he doing here? Suplex, no, oh, drops him on his chest on the barricade, on that retaining wall. Let AJ hang out with his fans in the front row. Sean Nice taunting Mr. Money in the Bank from the apron, and oh, a leg drop on that barricade, doing big time damage here. This is not good for AJ Hawks. Sean Nice, tell the referee, count this one out. Two, and that's all. You've got to believe that that attack was preemptive. AJ Hawks never saw it coming. Kind of Sean Nice knew exactly what he was doing here tonight. When is this war between these two men going to end? I mean, look at this. Oh, hanging him out there on that barricade. I hate to say something like this about AJ Hawk, a hell of a competitor, and one hell of a Mr. Money in the Bank, but he never stood a chance. Shawn Knight punched him right in the back of the head before this match ever even started. I didn't think he was going to even be able to continue here. AJ Hawk tried to make it to the ring, tried to reset things in his favor, and Shawn Knight was like a piranha in a pool of blood, just in a frenzy to finish off AJ Hawk. Folks, we're going to take a quick commercial break, and we will be right back. Don't you go anywhere.
I just woke up. I'm sore. I'm beat up. And it just hit me. I am the ECW World Heavyweight Champion. It just hit me, ladies and gentlemen. And tonight on Raw, this is going to be my first night of my new reign. Tonight, I face the bumbling, pathetic boy named Blade Wyatt. And see, Blade, this is an opportunity for you, though it probably won't be a very successful one. But you get to be a part of history, Blade Wyatt. You are going to be the first man that I destroy with my new reign. ECW. What did I say? What did I say, ECW? I proved you all wrong yet again. I proved it that I will be, that, well, I am now, that I am the ECW World Heavyweight Champion. I dropped Ryan Azrael 18 foot in the air onto a table and beat the shit out of him. And I digress, he threw it just as much back at me. And I don't think me and him are done at all. But, ladies and gentlemen, that doesn't matter right now. Right now, all that matters is that I'm the ECW World Heavyweight Champion. And it's mine. And no one's taking it from me. Not anymore.
Well, there's some words from your new World Heavyweight Champion, ladies and gentlemen, Jeremy McLaughlin, as we are back for our main event here. Blade Wyatt is on his way to the ring. And this is interesting. This man has a victory over Jeremy McLaughlin, beating him clean last month on, well, no, excuse me, 2 months ago on SmackDown. I am getting my timetable all mixed up here tonight. Yes, that was week 3 of May, Management Mayhem. Blade Wyatt got to go one-on-one with Strapping Young Lad and came out victorious in that encounter. Well, if he can do it again here tonight, this time with McLaughlin as the champion, I think this might be the definitive moment in Blade Wyatt's young career. Blade Wyatt has always been one who has struggled to find his positioning here in the shark tank that is El Dorado Championship Wrestling. And he's feeling confident about his chances here tonight. You know, hopefully he doesn't make the same mistake that Dash made in our matchup earlier in the broadcast. Dash at Nasty Bones also thought that he would be able to go 2-0 over his rival SNC and came up very short and hard in that match. Excuse me. So this should be interesting. I have to do say this though, McLaughlin, who went through 3 matchups last night, and good lord, if you didn't see it, folks, that first tag team match, him and Kyle Park versus Ed Gucci and Steve McCarty went 40 minutes. It was an insane tag team match. People are saying it might be the tag team match of the year. The carnage that ensued in what was supposed to be that fatal four-way, but became a triple threat. And oh my god, he already hit him with an Eastern Lariat. Oh my god, Blade Wyatt, this is it. That's it. It's got to be it. What? No! Blade Wyatt kicks out. Oh my god. Jerry McLaughlin. Just ruthless aggression from the opening bell. This has been a running theme here tonight, and I've completely lost my train of thought. I'm saying McLaughlin should be worse for wear here tonight, but it's not showing. Blade Wyatt had the night off. He was not a part of the tournament, nor the Money in the Bank ladder match. These two are eager to lock it up here, exchanging wrist locks and hammer locks. Back and forth we go. This is your main event, folks. We're going to follow it to the end here. Nice Fujiwara armbar takedown there by McLaughlin. He lifts him up. Oh, big head kick. Catches that one to the body and drops an elbow on the knee. This is the clothesline. McLaughlin from behind. What's this going to be? Belly to the back. Suplex. No, to a face buster. Throws him on his face. Those guys could be some animosity here. McLaughlin cannot be happy that he has lost a match to Blade Wyatt at all. But it is in the past. It is history. Blade Wyatt will not let go of that win. He talks about it every time it's brought up. It is all over his social media pages, folks. McLaughlin is just battering him here. Not even letting him get to his feet in the back rate. And now a standing, looks like a standing hammerlock modified Kimura there. The world champion is just all over this young man, Blade Wyatt. Look, oh my god, what a belly. Drops him over onto his belly there with that inverted suplex. I can't even get the words out. McLaughlin gonna take flight here. Perched on the top rope. We've seen him do this a couple times last night. Big diving drop kick. Down goes Blade Wyatt. And now looking to put Blade away. Going to try to hit that running Paragon knee in the face. No, he just countered Blade with the clothesline. And a Russian leg sweep from the Outlaw. The Lone Wolf VCW. Oh, this is another Eastern Larry. Jerry McLaughlin is just wanting to get this thing over with. And nice T-bone from the champion. Two-time World Heavyweight Champion, that is Jerry McLaughlin, dropping an elbow. Fast and furious here in the main event. Wayne White, big forearm shot. Big explosive bit, a second forearm shot. Building up momentum, Doc. And a spine buster. We've seen this a million times from Wayne White making the comeback. McLaughlin taking a breather on the outside of the ring here. Oh, and a running, turns around, it's a running big boot there. Blade White gets back to his feet though and throws McLaughlin into the barricade. And now just content just to punch him in the face as many times as you can. Oh, didn't catch all of it, but he still clipped him with that lariat. Oh, and he got all of that when Blade White laid out for another Eastern Lariat. The damage has definitely been done here. Blade White, slow to get to his feet. Ooh, Blade White has ever in his life been hit by a clothesline like that. Wait, McLaughlin tried to use that steel chair, but Blade catches him. Belly back power slam, forcing McLaughlin to take another breather outside the ring here. McLaughlin throws him, oh, face first into the ring steps. Ouch. Back and forth here. Dangerously close to those ring steps again. What is this? They are just back and forth with these reversals, hold for hold. Oh, Blade White sticks him with a punch and delivers a belly-to-belly slam. Oh, it's a big kick from McLaughlin. Oh, no. He can't do this. He should be disqualified. He can't do this. Pile driver on the floor. Trying to break Blade Wyatt's neck on the arena floor. Oh, just, oh my God. As hard as he can throw him at that range. Careening Blade Wyatt into those ring steps again. The referee sees the steel chair and finally gets it out of the ring. Oh, and look at that. He was going to try to throw him face first into that chair. Big King Kong-like smash there in the turnbuckle. Jerry McLaughlin is ready to put this thing to bed. Wait a second. Up against the rope. Blade White. Oh, counter. Forearm shot. But Jerry rebounds for another Eastern Lariat, and that has got to be all. I still see the effects of that King Extreme tournament. Jerry McLaughlin was unable to make the pin there. Looking for the DDT, but gets countered by Blade Wyatt. Blade from behind, another belly to back slam, and this can do it. Jerry can't get out of the ring this time. One. Oh, only a one count. The strapping young lad prevails. What a main event here, folks. Blade White shoots him into that turnbuckle. He can't even catch himself falling to the ground. Champion rolling out here again right in front of us. Oh, no. Belly to back suplex on the floor right in front of us. You can hear the thud. Blade White head bouncing off that mat, just echoing. Come on now. Jerry McLaughlin put Tyson Black through our announce table 2 months ago at Payback, and now we're going to do the same thing to Blade White. Wait, a suplex it? No. Stuffs the suplex and fights through it. Blade Wyatt, smooth as press. He needs to get in the ring. He does not want to take this by count out here. Both of them being counted out will do nothing for either man, as the champion looks like he's out from those punches. A 7 count here. He's got 3 seconds left to get in the ring. 8. Blade White can take this by count. No. I thought he was going to take it by count out there. McLaughlin shoots him into the ropes. What's this going to be? Oh, misses the lariat. Jerry McLaughlin so desperate. Wait, he rolls it up and he's got his hand on the trunk. 2, 3. The referee could not see it from where he was at, but McLaughlin had a handful of tight. Jerry McLaughlin sealing this victory. Look at that. There's that clothesline at the beginning of the match. Here's the end. Look at this. He rolled through and he's got his hand on the tights there. The referee couldn't see it. Well, there's your World Heavyweight Champion, ladies and gentlemen. Redeeming that loss to Blaine Wyatt previously. This is Brian Cole, folks. I'm going to have to get out of here for the evening. I'll catch up with you all later this week for SmackDown. We'll have more news on that. But in the meantime, have a great night, folks, and I will see you all next time here on the ECW Network.